to my blog. So, hey, today I want to talk about a conversation that my team and I had in our team meeting the other day. And we're really focusing right now and between now and the end of the year. So we created a very small mini business plan, very precise, very tight business plan to know exactly what we're going to be doing in the remaining days that we're working here in October for November and December. Now guys, number one is when starting off and doing a mini business plan, make it very simple. One page sheet, here it is, just like this. My guys wrote down basically their goals for the month, what we're going to keep them accountable for, and obviously myself as well. So a couple topics, a couple items that we wanted to cover. Number one is, for the remaining of this year, okay, the remaining days left in October, how many days will you be working? How many days will you be working in November? How many days will you be working in December? You need to lay that out. Get a calendar in front of you and look. With all the holiday parties coming up, you've got Thanksgiving, you've got Christmas, you've got breaks, school, kids getting out, the whole deal. How many actual days are you going to work for the remaining October, November, and December? You need to be very, very clear on that. So right now in the next week or so, maybe there's 5 days left of work, let's say in October or so next week, say, you know, 5-7 days. And then November, normally there's about 20 work days in each month, but you're gonna have Thanksgiving coming off, so forth, and then you've got Christmas. So, for example, I'm only working probably 15 total days maybe in the month of December over the Christmas break, everything else. So, gotta know exactly, so you're efficient in your time, how many days you're gonna be working, and then you need to schedule, put in your schedule for each of those days. So a couple things to look at right now to set goals for the month, okay, for the remaining 3 months here, October, November, December. Number one is, how many listings are you able to take? Really look at this. With your days being worked, how many more listings are you committed for? So write this down if you're going to take this, take notes on this for this business plan, okay? Listings taken. How many are you committed to get signed right now, okay? So number one is listings taken. Number two, if you have listings right now, listings sold. Look at your inventory. Go through it and say, okay, in the next 60 days, how much of this inventory is going to sell? And if it's not going to sell, what has to happen? What are the conversations with the sellers? What needs to happen with this inventory to create these listings to sell? So make it a goal. Number one, listings taken. Number two, listings sold. How many of these are you committed to get listings sold for the remaining of the year? For the remaining of this month, what will sell in November? What will sell in December? Because it may take you 30 days to work on a reduction with a seller so that it sells sometime in December. Lay that out, identify the listings, and say, okay, in the next 2 weeks, this listing or these listings are going to sell. For November, here's the goal to get these sold in November. Here's the goal to get these sold in December. Write that out so you've got how many listings taken. Third item we wrote down here is buyer sales, buyer-controlled sales. If you're working with buyers, how many buyer sales are you going to have? Okay, between now and again, remaining in the month, November and December. How many appointments can you set today? How many appointments can you set for next weekend already if it's buyers? You know, how are you blocking that out? Do you try to say a minimum standard, have 2 buyers out a weekend, or is it 4? You know, do you time block, say, in squares? You know, my guys, what we do is we have 2 time slots. You know, say 11 to 2 on Saturday, and then say from 2 to 4 on Saturday, and then same thing on Sunday. We try to plug in, you know, at the top on each one of them, each square here, buyers, so they're out with 4 different buyers every weekend, okay? Or again, listing appointments, whichever way. So you've got buyer-controlled sales. Third part of the business plan is reductions. Okay, if you've got inventory, how many price reductions are you going to get? Again, every price reduction today is like a new listing. So are you working on price reductions? How many can you commit to right now, the remaining this month, November, and December? All right, so think about that. Now, also the good part, income. How much income are you committed to generate? So if you want to have an unbelievable Christmas, Is it possible you could create a deal now in October and have it still close, say, in the next 30, 45 days? Is it possible? Absolutely. So some of the deals you're writing right now, you still can get them done and close by Christmas or the end of the year, this calendar year, okay? So how much income do you want to create the remaining of this year right now? Be focused on that. Is that $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000? Take a look at what your average commission is and make it a goal and say, I'm gonna create this much income between now and the end of the year, all right? And for it to close this year. Think about that. So, also you wanna look at right now is, what is your closed income that you have so far for the year? How much have you earned in your pocket? How much do you have pending right now with transactions that are coming up to close? Add the two together, there's your closed and pending income. Add on now your new goal on how much you're gonna create this year, And now that's going to give you an idea as far as your income for this year. Yes, you may be pushing some deals in the next year at this time. I get that. But let's focus on the next, you know, the next 2.5 months right now. Be tight on this and really make that happen. Now, part of this process, I also write down here, education. What are you going to be doing in your head? All right. How are you going to be educating yourself? Are you listening to any motivational tapes? Are you listening to anything from Mike Ferry? Are you listening to anything else that's going to motivate you, keep you accountable? What books are you reading? What are you listening to? What exactly are you doing? Are you role playing? Are you listening to any of Mike's daily messages? What are you actually doing every single day to get educated and keep yourself focused? This time of year coming in, it can be very distractible. A lot of things going on. But have a little mini business plan written out. Okay, have it there. And then also what I recommend is go find somebody right now and make sure they keep you accountable to this, all right? Whoever that is, find somebody, write this business plan out, write your schedule out, and then take everything and give it to somebody and say, hey, this is my goals, here's what I'm up to, keep me accountable to it, all right? If you need me to, send me an email, I'll help you do it as well, okay? So find somebody that's out there, and then also post this business plan that you have, you know, in front of you everywhere, at home, put it on your refrigerator, if you've got kids, you've got wife, you know, whatever's going on, say, hey, here's my plan between now and the end of the year. This is what I'm doing every day. Here's what I'm committed to. Here's what I want to make happen, okay? So think about that. Hopefully these tips have helped you design a tiny little business plan to review again, listings taken, listings sold, buyer control sales, price reductions, figure out income generated, know where you are, closed and pending income, add that on, and then also what education are you going to be doing between now and the end of the year? Are you going to any seminars, whatever it may be, to keep you pumped? This is the time of year. It's easy to back off. This time of year, you got to keep plugging, all right? So get the mini business plan together, get somebody to keep you accountable to it, and finish strong in the remaining of the year. If I can help you out anyway, send me an email. If you like this video, go ahead and forward it, subscribe it, get it to another realtor friend of yours, whomever it may be, and we'll rock and roll from there. Also, guys, on the side of this training block here, you're going to see all the affiliates of which that I use, all the services that I use for obviously being successful in the business. Click on any one of those. You'll see who we use, who we get our numbers from, just exactly all the products that we use and integrate within our business for technology, everything else. So go ahead and take a look there if you need to click on them and use any of their services. These guys are great. All right. Anything else you need, send me an email or call me. Thanks so much for watching. And again, I look forward to our conversation next time, being the best of your day.